Hello, it's me.
This is Viv in Madrid.
Pienso que un sueño parecido no volverá más. Y me pintaba las manos y la cara de azul.
So this is a video about my time in Spain and my ideas on their culture and some of their history and how it's affected me throughout my stay.
Y de provisa el viento rápida me llevó y me hizo volar en el cielo infinito.
The thing I really do like about Spanish culture is the ability to drink, you know, every day basically with a meal, just a glass of wine, and they don't have to get like really pissed and drunk, you know. In Australia often it's like a bit more binge drinking. If you have one beer you have 10, you know, and a chug down of vodka as well, kind of thing. So I really like that you can have a casual drink much more easily here. It's really nice.
Balling.
The culture here is a lot more craze based, I'd say. There's a lot of fads in comparison to what I'm used to. Like, it's crazy lines for Primark and the lottery. Just, oh, and for that, the churreria with the chocolate San Ginés or something like that. Anyway, I walked past the other day and it was like, the line was like 2 meters long. It's crazy. We'd never line up for that in Australia. Actually, to be honest, there's just not enough people.
Tiene casi 20 años y ya está cansado de soñar. Pero tras la frontera está su hogar, su mundo y su ciudad. Piensa que la alambrada solo es un trozo de metal.
So there's a lot of great artwork in Spain, as we all know, and we are lucky enough in Madrid to have one of the best museums in the world, the Prado Museum. So I went and visited it, which I hope you have as well, by the way. I was blown away, I was amazed, so I decided to research into some of the details and the history behind it. So basically, 1785, Charles III commissions this amazing royal museum. It's his grandson, Ferdinand VII, who gets convinced by his wife to make it a national museum, and it has been ever since. So this is a cool story, but what I find the most amazing behind the history of the Prado Museum is the effort that went into saving the artworks during times of unrest and times of danger. July 17th, 1936, the civil war kind of starts to take shape with an uprising in Morocco. So it's amazing what they did. Basically, they shut down the Prado Museum, they took out all of the artworks, put them underground in the basement. They put sandbags around the fountains and the statues so they wouldn't break. They wrote down every single piece of art they had. Anyway, after this, everything was moved to Valencia for safety's sake, which is a feat in itself. I mean, there's 2,300 artworks in the Prado Museum at the moment, approximately. Think about the work that went into that, right? And they don't even have the technology that we have at the moment. So everything's moved to Valencia. Civil war continues to get out of hand. So they move it to Geneva in Italy. 4 days before the World War II starts to take shape, where Germany invades Poland, the artwork is restored to Spain, and Spain didn't really have direct involvement in World War II. So, I mean, the artwork stayed safe. Lucky for us, we can still enjoy it. And it's all thanks to the amazing work of these past people who cared about art just as much as we do. Thanks.
Dale a tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Dale a tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, Macarena.
Paya tomorrow night. Ole, 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 ole.
Alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Dale a tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, Macarena.
Basically, the reason why I decided to come to Spain for exchange over another country was because I make Spanish paella back at home in Perth. My God, there's nothing in the fridge. Anyway, so I work with these Spanish guys. They always tell me about Spain. So I thought I'd come and check it out for myself, have some real Spanish paella. So that's what I've done. I went to Valencia. I tried it. Honestly, it wasn't that good, but I found some really tasty ones in Madrid, as you've just seen from my video. Backstory to paella. Old Moorish kings used to have these lavish banquets. The servants would take the leftovers home after work and add them to their rice, and thus paella was born. Anyway, it's one of my favourite foods. I'm keen to try out some of the recipes that I've discovered here when I get back to work.
Enrique Iglesias.
Culture shock thing for me was being on the other side of the road. So in Australia, we drive and we stand on the left-hand side. Over here, you stand on drive on the right. So everything in a car is the other way around. And as you can see, I was in the Gran Canaries, and me and my friends had this mad idea that we would rent a car, and that I would drive with my automatic license. I would drive a manual car on the other side of the road with the gear sticks on the other side of the road. I'm alive, look. I'm alive. So I want to talk about today is San Sebastian. I went there with two friends on the 30th of August. And turns out, by the look of my video, we came at a crazy time. So there is this huge festival on the 31st of August that is a remembrance day of the siege of San Sebastian. So just in case you don't know, San Sebastian is on the top of Spain, close to the border of France, right? So there was this British guy called Duke of Wellington, and he wanted to invade France. And the issue was that San Sebastian was in the way. So he decided to get rid of San Sebastian and the men that were there under General Louis Ray. And so he invades the place, and they have this huge siege that lasts for 6 days. I think it was from the 25th to the 31st. The entire city gets burned, and one street at the foot of the hill is safe. Now, by pure chance, me and my friends decided to stay on this street, in the oldest building in the whole city. It's crazy. It was the cheapest hostel. That's why we chose it. Anyways, we slowly arrive, and there's this huge festival going. They're doing this huge reenactment with guns, and people are dying. It was the most incredible historical sort of experience that I've had in my whole life, and I just feel so lucky that I ended up amongst it.
Solo se vive una vez. Si te importa el que dirán y te quieren controlar, recuérdalo.
Spain has affected me in so many more ways than I've been able to explain in this 6-minute video, right? You can't fit it in. But anyway, this is the end of my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a very Merry Christmas and a great holiday. Can't wait to see you sometime in the future.